Today's topic is about rounding numbers up or down. So before that, let's see what is the meaning of rounding. Rounding means bringing it to a closer value which is easier to understand. For example, you are going to a shop and you are buying a dress, okay, which costs rupees 493 something, okay. The next day you are wearing it for a party or something, and one of your friend is asking you what is the cost of your shirt, and you forget the exact rate, but you remember it's somewhere closer to 500, and you say my shirt costs rupees 500. So you have rounded the value 493 to an easier value 500, which is easier for you to remember as well as to understand. So this is nothing but rounding. So first, we will learn how to round numbers to the nearest 10. So one example is 359. You know the place value. So the digit 9 is in ones, and this is in tens, and this is in hundreds place. So we are going to round it to the nearest tens. So the nearest tens is the number 59. So when you see, we know tens as 10, 20, 30, up to 100. So 59 lies between these two numbers, 50 and 60. So which number to choose is what we are going to see. So just look at the last digit. So what is the last digit? It's 9. If the last digit is above 5, that is 5 or 6, 5 and above 5, 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 or 9, you are going to round it down. If the number is below 5, like 4, 3, 2, 1 or 0, you're going to round it up. So what does up and down mean? So above 5, so the number is 9 and it is above 5. So you're going to round down. That means you're going to choose the number which is down. So the number which is down is 60. So this can be rounded as 360. Okay, for example, if here the number was 352, so now how can you round up? The number, the last digit is below 5, so it is below 5, which is 2. So you have to round it up. Round it up means the number which is up, which is on top, 350. So you can round this number as 350. So this is the basic thing. You have to check the last number. If it is above 5, you have to round it down. If it is below 5, you have to round it up. See, taking this example, so if you can see, this is in ones, tens, hundreds. So hundreds place is 359. So while rounding it to the nearest 100, you're going to see the last two digits. If the last two digit is above 50, you're going to round down. So where 359 lies, it is between 300 and 400. So we have to check which of these two numbers we have to choose. So the last two numbers is above 50. So it's above 50, so you have to round down. Round down means the number which is down is 400. So this can be written as 400. When you round it off to the nearest 100. If we see another example, for example, here the number was, say, 310. Okay, now the last two digit is below 50. Below means lesser than 50, so you have to round up. So round up means the number which is on top is 300. So you can round this number to the nearest 100 as 300. So in this way, you can round any number to either nearest tens or hundreds using your values given.